we are at the breeding facility for the endangered Pacific pocket mouse off exhibit at the San Diego Zoo Safari Park.
We have an awful lot that's going on, looking at breeding, foraging, response to predators, and it's all there to help us learn more about the species, help us breed more of the species, and then release them back into the wild. A Pacific pocket mouse is incredibly cute.
It's the smallest mouse in North America.
Only weighs about the same as 3 pennies. They have these little pockets. In these pockets, they can put all their seeds and stuff inside it and go and store them for later. They're adorable. When they're first born, they're sort of a reddish pink. I describe them as a pink jelly bean. They're very, very small. They have no fur. They have the tiniest little bumps on the side of their head where their ears are going to start developing. And of course, their eyes are completely closed. You start seeing the skin turning gray and they get what we call a pup fur, which is a very, very fine gray fur. And after about 2.5 to 3 weeks, they will then start to open their eyes and explore outside of the nest jar, if mama lets them, because she likes to grab them and take them back into the nest jar to keep them safe.
Because this captive breeding facility was designed for reintroducing the species back into the wild, we wanted to make sure we replicated critical environmental cues when we developed the facility. Skylights in the room so that we have natural day length and seasonality. We keep everything under red lights at night. Because the mice are nocturnal, we believe that they see red as being pitch black.
We have everything temperature and humidity controlled. That way we can mimic the temperatures and the humidity of the coastal regions where we find the Pacific pocket mouse in the wild. They have sand for lots of burrowing and digging. They especially like it when it's nice and damp and fresh. We also make a nest jar and a burrow for them out of tubes and piping.
And that's what they turn it into.
These are the chips that are going into the mice. Each one of these is an individual ID.
You might be able to see the tag if I push up the plunger.
Because the mice are nocturnal, we have to completely shift our schedule to become nocturnal like the mice. So half of the year, basically my entire staff becomes nocturnal.
We use alcohol prep pads to sterilize the tail before we do the implantation of the tag. Look at that tail, so cute.
The Pacific pocket mouse is historically distributed from the El Segundo Dunes in Los Angeles near where the LA airport is down to the US-Mexico border in the Tijuana River Valley. We discovered the Dana Point population in 1994. It was thought to be extinct at that time. In 1995, we discovered 3 additional populations on Marine Corps Base Camp Pendleton. We wouldn't be able to do the reintroduction effort without OC Parks, which is providing the reintroduction site.
I was going to use yellow for cages.
Okay.
And pink for fence.
This is the 4th population that we've created here. Current site is just slightly over 1 acre.
Yeah, well, there's one gap between the 2 polygons that are on the...
Well, Laguna Coast Wilderness Park is in the historic range of the species. The species has very strict habitat requirements. They live only 4 miles from the coast and no more. In that nest chamber, we've put nesting material, seeds, and a little bit of dirt. Each mouse is going to have its own cage because they're solitary, so they can go up and down in here for a week. That period of time seems to allow them to acclimate to the site. There's a second burrow that comes up from the underground chamber and comes out over here. And that burrow just allows them to have 2 escapes. And we are also training them in captivity to be prepared for interacting with predators.
So for predator training to prepare the animals for release, we have an arena which is full of sand.
We need a speaker and a smartphone. And most importantly, we need a snake.
And in the area where we'll put the mice, we have buckwheat, which is a local native plant, which they would use in the wild for shelter. And we'll also put a burrow in there so that they have somewhere to hide. What we would do is put the snake in his special compartment, introduce the mouse into their compartment. Snakes and mice can see each other and smell each other, but they can't touch each other or access each other at all. And then as they approach the snake, we'll make a loud noise and also play a pocket mouse alarm call. And then that way they're going to associate approaching the snake with something negative. And that way we can train them that snakes are not something that they want to be getting anywhere near in the wild. And it gives them the survival skills they need.
We can swoop out down on the mice to avoid an aerial predator.
Today we're preparing to release 50 Pacific pocket mice into the wild for the first time. We have metal containers called Sherman Trats, and they are all identified with the cage that they're going to at the release site, and we will be putting in nest material and some seed during the transportation. They're nocturnal, so we wanted to transport them near dusk. We will stay until the last one goes down into the nest chamber. And this one is your native seed.
Open it up. Put it through the bars.
Yeah.
And... oh, he's got something.
Here she is.
I've always loved these little guys. I think that a lot of people pull for more charismatic, larger species, but these are tiny and they're nocturnal and no one even knows that they're here, but they're super important for the ecosystem. So it's really exciting to be bringing them back. We'll hold them here for 7 days and then we'll release everybody. The release went extremely well. We started out with just a discussion about how it was going to go, a little bit about a description of how to walk gently through the site since the pocket mice would be coming up above ground that they wouldn't get trampled while we were out there. We pulled off the cap that covered the secondary burrow. We pulled cages off the above ground portion of the cage. They have scented the dirt with their own sebaceous glands, their own scent. And if you spread that scent around, the idea is that it starts to help them establish territory. So it may dampen stress and also communicate to others that this is now their home. We use night vision goggles to do observations on the Pacific pocket mouse so that we can see what they're doing when they come above ground without having to use artificial light. They're doing everything we had hoped they would. Investigating, they're digging, they're sandbathing, they were foraging on the seeds that we provided for them, and they were wary. They were using their temporary cages that we provided for them to acclimate to the site as homes, so they use them as a refuge. The below ground portion is entirely biodegradable, so they can literally start digging their own burrow and establishing their burrow system. Below ground, the burrows would have multiple chambers with fairly short tunnels for raising pups. They could be used for storing seed, or they could be used for sleeping. The burrow systems are important because it helps them regulate their temperature. It also helps them protect themselves from predators because they can plug their burrows. They also increase soil hydrology through their digging activities, which facilitates nutrient cycling. It's been 1 month since we released the Pacific pocket mice out here onto Laguna Coast Wilderness Park. During our post-release trapping, we spend nights out here. We basically sleep in the truck or in a tent in between trap checks. So we're here almost 24 hours a day. During those periods where we're supplementary feeding, we feed 3 times a week. So we've basically been living at the site for the last several months.
Pacific pocket mice are a really important endangered species. Locations are limited to 3 and now 4. And so this is a really important project to be working on.
We're using these cameras to monitor their behavior.
It'll take 20-second videos.
Typically, they come above ground just at dusk. Some of the best camera footage is just watching the mice do what wild pocket mice do. They're doing everything we would expect. They're above ground, they're running around, they're foraging, they're sandbathing, and they're digging in front of the cameras.
We've got 1, 2. Go down to the bottom. Yeah.
Location.
Initially into.
We have seen the mice. They look great. They're very healthy, good weights.
This is a female.
They're in good condition in terms of their pelage.
Scan her tail, and I got her.
Everybody looks good. We have about 50% of the animals in our traps, so we know that they're here. We consider that to be a minimum estimate of what's out here because some animals are just trap shy. So I'm thrilled that at 1 month post, they're doing great. It's almost a Herculean task to take on out here. We have a great deal of help from our pocket mouse partners.
We're working on healing the ecosystem. We're putting back a piece that is missing that was there originally.
Always wear a headlamp, watch where you're walking, and be careful with the mice.
Seeing the animals back out in the wild is, I don't even know how to describe it.
Tremendously exciting, you know, creating diversity and creating a healthy ecosystem is what our mission is here at Laguna Coast, and to be able to add to the diversity of species is only going to make our park that much better and that much more viable and be able to last for generations to come.
So we'll come back out at 3 months post-release and do another round of trapping, and then we will wait till next year.